Hey, what's up guys? It's great to see you all again. And if you're new here, I'm Patrick, and this is where I ramble about tech and other stuff. So, wow, it's been a hectic couple of weeks in iPhone land. This year, since I now have a YouTube channel, instead of just picking one and buying it, I decided to order all three sizes, review them, and then make up my mind. And obviously, I'll only be keeping one. I'm not rich. The only phone I haven't ordered is the 12 Pro because it doesn't make a lot of sense to me. If you've seen my previous videos, you know why, and if you haven't, feel free to click on the card up here to find out. So, I've used and reviewed the regular 12, I've used and reviewed the Mini, and this week, I've been spending a lot of time with the Pro Max, and today, I'm gonna give you my thoughts on that. Maybe it'll help you a little. So, let's ramble. Hold up, things go wild when I pull up, they all on me like it wants. All right, so if there's one thing that has become painfully clear, it's that this year has easily been the most difficult year to pick the right iPhone. I'm not gonna talk about which phone I'm gonna pick. Today, I just wanna focus on the Pro Max and tell you all the things that are great and some things I don't like so much. So let's start with the phone itself. The way it looks, the way it feels, I mean, there's no denying that this is a beautiful piece of technology. The boxy design is absolutely my favorite. The screen is very flat, I love it. It's much more practical than the rounded edges on the 11 Pro Max. It makes the phone feel leaner and you get more screen real estate. I love the premium feel of the stainless steel, even though I'm not a fan of the fingerprints. The graphite, I think, is the best color. I mean, I know a lot of people were looking forward to all the funky new colors, but I really think this is the one. Plus, if you don't like the color, get a nice case. My iPhone lives in its case, so it doesn't really matter that much what color it is. Another reason why you should probably get a case is this. The fact that the camera lenses stick out the way they do makes the phone very wobbly when it's on a flat surface. When you put a case around it, the wobble is gone, and the lenses are protected as they no longer hit the table. Now, of course, this wobble is not unique to the Pro Max, as all models have the same camera bump. However, because it's so large, I'm much more likely to use the phone while flat on the table, and trying to type with a wobble just isn't gonna work. So let's talk about this screen. That screen. It has the same beautiful OLED HDR screen with all the pixel goodness, there's just more of it. It has the same brightness as the Pro, which means 800 nits standard and 1200 nits in HDR mode. But again, there's just more of it to enjoy. The bump in brightness over the regular 12 in the Mini is especially useful when you're outside on a bright day and it can be a little hard to see the screen. Whether you're watching content, doing some work, using the amazing camera, or playing a game, if that's what you're into, the screen on this phone just makes it an absolute pleasure to use. I tend to switch between three devices when I'm working. I'm either using my phone, my iPad Pro, or my MacBook Pro attached to an ultra-wide monitor like the one on my desk. It depends on the task which device I prefer to use. Now, the big screen on the 12 Pro Max makes it quite easy and enjoyable to do all sorts of tasks on the phone for extended periods of time without feeling the need to switch to my iPad or my MacBook. And I quite like that. When using a small phone, I find myself putting off certain tasks until later because I need a bigger screen. Which is not a big deal, but I do like the convenience of being able to do it all on the Pro Max. Reading is more enjoyable as well, and obviously that won't come as a surprise to you. What's interesting though is that what you see on the phone isn't just a bigger version of the smaller models, you actually see a bigger portion of whatever content you're looking at. So let's just take this website for example. Compared to the Mini, you can see that it actually shows more of the website, not just a bigger version of the same portion. What's funny is that I even found myself on our couch in front of our massive 65-inch TV watching YouTube on my phone. Usually I stream my content to my television, but using the Pro Max, I sometimes just forgot. And gaming is an absolute treat. I mean, in my review of the Mini, I made a little fun of the gaming aspect as my thumbs would cover up a good portion of the screen. Not this guy. You can comfortably place your thumbs and still have plenty of that luscious screen left to enjoy your game. The same goes for the typing experience. I just prefer a larger keyboard. I think it's easier to type.
Not only do I keep missing the mark on the smaller phones, my hands feel a lot less crampy on the Pro Max as well. However, I do need to clarify that I've been using the biggest phones for many years, whether it's the iPhone 11 Pro Max or Samsung flagships, and typing on small phones might just be something I can get used to again. But for now, I enjoy typing on the big boy more. Now, a bigger screen means more power consumption, which requires a bigger battery, and luckily, the Pro Max has that. I can easily take the Pro Max off the charger in the morning, use it extensively all day, and not worry at all about it dying on me. This is not the case for the 12 mini. And of course, let's not forget about the camera, arguably the biggest selling point of this phone. Just like the Pro Max has an additional telephoto lens, which allows for optical zoom and improved portrait photos. However, the 12 Pro Max has even better zoom ranges. It can digitally zoom up to 12 times, and it has a 5 times optical zoom, whereas the smaller Pro has a 10 times digital zoom and an optical zoom of 4 times. Not a huge difference, but it's there. Also, both the 12 Pro and the Pro Max have the LiDAR scanner. I've been able to play around with it a little on my iPad Pro, which has one as well, but while it still feels a bit like a gimmick on the iPad Pro, I think it is much more convenient on the iPhone and you're much more likely to use it in real life. The most obvious use case of LiDAR is, of course, low light filming or photography. I took out both the Mini and the Pro Max in the dark just to compare how well they would do and whether we can see a clear difference in quality. It's also worth noting that the Pro Max has a camera sensor which is almost twice the size of the other models, which lets in even more light and should theoretically result in even better low light performance. So, is the Pro Max the phone for you? Well, that depends. If you're someone who likes to use their phone to do most things, who doesn't like having to switch between devices, are you someone who travels a lot or are you away from your desk for long periods of time, then the Pro Max certainly offers you a lot of options, as well as a killer battery. Are you somebody who cares a great deal about the camera, then most likely you're gonna love using the Pro Max. But if you only use your phone to snap the occasional picture, if you value the convenience of a smaller phone over the added performance the Pro Max has to offer, if you don't really care about gaming and you just want to browse social media and watch a bit of content every now and then, the Pro Max is probably not the one for you and you would be better off buying a Mini or a regular 12. I hope this video has been useful to you. If it has, give it one of these and please subscribe to the channel for more content like this. Thank you so much for watching and see you in the next one.